So in this lecture, we will see the point and non-point sources of pollution. So we'll see what is this point and non-point sources of pollution. So first, we'll see the point sources of pollution. They comes from a specific source. We can specify the source, just like a pipe or a factory, like that we can specify the source. That kind of sources are known as point sources of pollution. It is basically a source you can directly point to. Example, factories, industry, municipal treatment plants, etc. And it can be monitored and controlled by a permit system, because we know the exact source, so we can control it. And here you can see that the point source of pollutants in surface water and groundwater are usually found in a plume that has the highest concentration of the pollutant near the source, such as the end of a pipe or an underground injection system, and diminishing concentration farther away from the source. So here in this figure, you can see here there is a pipe which discharges this pollutant into this river. So this shape is known as plume. It has higher concentration near the source, near the end of a pipe. Okay, so it has higher concentration near the source, and the concentration decreases as it is away from the source. Here the concentration of the pollutants will be less. Here it will be higher because it is discharging at this side. So the point sources of pollution can be seen in the form of a plume. So this is a figure from Ohio River. A point source of pollution which is discharged from a drainage outlet into the Ohio River. And the different kinds of pollution which can cause this point sources are commercial and industrial businesses. Regarding the agricultural point sources, the animal feeding operation, animal waste treatment lagoon, storage, handling, mixing, all these type of processes can deliver some amount of pollutants. So these type of fertilizers, petroleum, etc., all these kinds of pollutants can be termed as point sources. The municipal point sources are wastewater treatment plants, landfills, utility stations, motor pools, fleet maintenance facilities. So all these things comes under municipal point sources. The raw materials and waste may include pollutants such as solvents, petroleum products, heavy metals, etc. So all these can causes pollution to the water sources. In groundwater, the point source pollutants are volatile organic compounds, which include manufactured and refined toxic substances like solvents, oils, paint, fuel products, etc. In case of surface water, high temperature discharge, microorganisms, nutrients, etc. can cause pollution. So they can all be categorized as point source of pollution. Now we will move on to non-point source of pollution. We cannot point out a particular source in case of non-point source. So examples are a runoff water. So runoff is generally associated with non-point source pollution, as water is emptied into streams or rivers after accumulating contaminants from sources like gardens, parking lots, or construction sites. We can say that the runoff water will be traveling through many places. It will be carrying pollutants from many places. So we cannot exactly point out a particular point source. So we can say that the runoff water is a non-point source of pollution. And a non-point source pollution is a combination of pollutants from a large area rather than from specific identifiable sources such as discharge pipes. It is usually found spread out throughout a large area, and it occurs as water moves across the land or through the ground and picks up natural and human-made pollutants, which can then be deposited in lakes, rivers, wetlands, coastal waters, and even groundwaters. It can be caused mainly due to the movement of water through different planes. Okay. So it is often difficult to trace the exact origin of these pollutants. These are the examples of non-point source pollution: oil and grease from cars, fertilizers, animal waste, grass clippings, septic systems. All these can be a source of non-point source pollution in water. In urban areas, the parking lots, streets, roads, grease, metal, dirt, salts, and other toxic materials can cause non-point source pollution. And in residential areas, irrigation, rainfall, septic systems, etc. can cause non-point source pollution. Bacteria and microorganisms are another things which can cause pollution. They can be formed mainly from septic systems of residential areas. So we cannot say that which particular system caused that production of bacteria. So it can be from many sources. We cannot point out an exact source. So it can be categorized as a non-point source pollution. So in this picture, we can see the different point and non-point sources of pollution. So the non-point sources are urban streets, suburban development, cropland, fertilizers and pesticide from this cropland can be discharged into this water stream. Animal feed lot, we can give feeds to the animals, but some amount will be traced through this runoff water. It will be brought to this river through the runoff water. From rural homes, some waste will be carried by this runoff water. So all these are non-point sources of pollution. Now point sources are wastewater treatment plant. We can exactly point out which is the source. Here the wastewater treatment plant discharges water, wastewater into this river. So that is a point source. Factory can discharge sewage. So all these are point sources. Now how can we control these kinds of pollution? The point sources of pollution can be controlled by the US Environmental Protection Agency. They have, EPA have given certain acts and rules to prevent such kind of pollutions. It can regulate the point sources of pollution through issuing of permits that limit the types. So the factories and other industrial companies have been given with certain permits. So this much amount of waste they can dispose. Like that, some permits will be given by EPA. So by using that permits, we can control such kind of pollution. Regarding the non-point source pollution, we have to implement Clean Water Act and other watershed protection efforts. Such kind of efforts can only limit this non-point sources of pollution. So this is about today's lecture. Thank you.